And now, a massive search on the open ocean after a cargo ship sinks.
Mariners don't fear too much, I don't think, but they fear this.
Friends and family holding out hope after this tragedy at sea.
The owner of the ship says mechanical failure left the vessel adrift before being hit by Hurricane Joaquin.
One body has already been discovered. Seven's Lorena Estrada live at the Coast Guard station in Miami Beach this morning with details. Lorena, good morning.
Good morning. The U.S. Coast Guard is on a mission. They say it's been more than 120 hours since they last made contact with the cargo ship El Faro. Their top priority now, they say, is to find survivors. A U.S. Coast Guard crew takes off early Tuesday morning, the mission to find survivors of El Faro. Loved ones of the missing crew members relying on faith and hope.
We are asking for your prayers, sincere prayers, because in this situation, that's all that we can do.
Cadet Keith Griffin of the Massachusetts Maritime Academy is one of the missing.
Really holding out hope that we get some perhaps surprising good news with maybe a Coast Guard discovery sooner rather than later.
The U.S. Coast Guard in the middle of a massive search in the Atlantic, but so far, no signs of survivors aboard the missing El Faro cargo ship, presumed to have gone down in rough water.
For our search planning efforts, we are assuming that the vessel has sank.
A debris field some 225 square miles across yielding this damaged lifeboat found off the coast of the Bahamas. It's confirmed to be one of the two El Faro had on board when it left Jacksonville Tuesday night for Puerto Rico.
It was heavily damaged. But it was recovered, no signs of life there.
Hurricane Joaquin slammed the ship and its crew of 28 Americans and 5 Polish nationals as a Category 4 storm. Crew started their search Friday, but weather conditions didn't improve until Sunday. Among the items found, a life ring and a body.
We lowered a rescue swimmer to confirm that the person was deceased, and it was basically unidentifiable.
Long-range aircraft from the Coast Guard, Navy, and Air Force have scanned 73,000 miles so far. The mission still focused on finding survivors. The NTSB held a news conference earlier this morning. There they said that they are going to be looking into what happened, why, so that they can prevent something like this from happening again. We're live in Miami Beach, Lorena Estrada, today in Florida.